Huanglongbing, also called citrus greening, is an invasive disease of citrus that is devastating the Florida citrus industry in the U.S. and threatening other major citrus-producing regions. This disease causes significant crop loss for citrus growers. HLB travels through the plant and affects all parts of the plant. This means that a treatment for HLB must be applied systemically. In the first video in this series, Zinkicide, a safe new treatment for HLB, we explore how Zinkicide, a bactericide that uses nanotechnology, moves inside the phloem to reach all structures of the tree, roots, shoots, and stems. However, the dilution effect means that any treatment is going to lose effectiveness as it travels further from where it is applied. This is also due to the time it takes for Zinkicide to diffuse to the central parts of the tree that are furthest away from application. This is true for Zinkicide, but also for any treatment you apply to trees, such as antibiotics or systemic insecticides. To remain effective, Zinkicide must be reapplied regularly. Any nano treatment loses efficacy as the nanoparticles dissolve. Nanoparticles designed not to linger in the environment may dissolve usually within 1 to 2 weeks. Because we're unlikely to kill all the bacteria in all leaves, roots, shoots, and stems, if you stop spraying, bacteria reinfect from the roots or other sheltered places that Zinkicide didn't access. On younger trees that aren't full-sized, Zinkicide can provide good efficacy. Tree health improves, with 50 to 60% yield improvements. However, bacterial populations still exist, especially in larger trees. On smaller trees, Zinkicide gets absorbed quickly by the tree, travels through the trunk and down into the roots before it starts to break down. With a larger tree, Zinkicide has to travel a larger distance once it's applied. It may not have time to reach all parts of the tree. The farther you get from the application site, the smaller number of nanoparticles you see. The size of the tree clearly makes a big difference on how well Zinkicide is able to work. The bigger the tree, the more Zinkicide will be needed to get an effective dose throughout the tree. If Zinkicide becomes too concentrated in one location on the surface, then phytotoxicity is likely to occur. Phytotoxicity means damage to the plant from a compound that has been applied. Currently, Zinkicide is being sprayed monthly, 12 months out of the year, on trees at the University of Florida Citrus Research and Education Center, CREC. In an upcoming field trial, researchers will try doing 4 to 8 sprays over a 2-month period to get a greater reduction in bacteria in a shorter time, making it harder for bacteria to rebound. This could provide a better method for larger trees. Another possible solution is trunk injection, which has been shown to be the most effective way to get Zinkicide into all the tree's structures. Because of labor costs, this might require development of a robotic system attached to a tractor in order to be economically viable. Researchers are working to find the best way to fight HLB with Zinkicide and overcome these challenges. Field trials are ongoing at the University of Florida Citrus Research and Education Center. Laboratory work on Zinkicide also continues at CREC, University of Central Florida, and other partner universities. Researchers are dedicated to helping growers find solutions that work for field conditions on the ground in Florida. This solution will take into account the dilution effect and properties of nanotechnology in order to ensure safe, economical, and effective application to optimize the treatment and fight back against HLB.